Okay, this is a bonus video. This isn't one that I planned to make, but I feel like I have to make it. Today is Saturday, 27th, and last Friday, I read an article exclaiming that, I'll just read the headline. Scientists achieve real-time communication with lucid dreamers in breakthrough study. I suppose they meant to finish the word with study. So what the study is, and I'll leave a link to the article below. The study proved that a person on the waking world can speak to a dreamer and the dreamer can respond. So the way that this worked was very similar to the way that proved that lucid dreaming existed back in 75. So eye signals. The dreamer has eye signals to the observer, the person who's awake. But what makes this different is that instead of the dreamer sending a signal to the waking world, it was the waking world that asked a mathematical question to the dreamer, and the dreamer responded with the correct answer. So this is huge because you can see the person's in sleep. You can see they're in REM using the thing, and then you can see their eye signals, which answers a question that you're asking. Massive news. The implications to this, I don't know what it would be. It further solidifies the fact that lucid dreaming is definitely a skill that you can build and develop on over time. Let me break down a little bit more about what happened. So the researchers got 36 people to fall asleep in a lab with the aim of entering a lucid state, and the person was aware that they were in a dream. So with all the technology that they placed on the people to measure brain activity and eyeball movements and stuff like that, once a person had entered deep sleep state, some of the participants were asked to confirm if they were in a dream with a pre-arranged ocular response. So this is exactly how they proved that lucid dreaming was a genuine phenomenon back in the day. Then they were asked questions. So one participant who was 19 years old in America was asked to subtract 6 from 8 whilst he was in a lucid dream, and he correctly answered 2 with 2 eye movements left to right. When he was asked again, he repeated the same answer, or the correct answer. Some of the individuals reporting that the prompt sounded like a voiceover narrator or a radio speaker that was clearly coming from their dream. It still has a high error rate. 60% of people didn't provoke any response, and only 18% of people produced a clear and accurate response from the dreamer. 17% of people produced indecipherable answers, and the 3% ended up with incorrect responses. I think it's amazing that this has come to light, because it proves something that we've already instinctively known for a very long time. You can hear things in the waking world. How many times have you been asleep and you've heard a really weird noise only to wake up and realize it's your alarm clock, or you hear some thumping and you wake up and realize someone's at your door? Or how many times have we seen these audio devices that go in our ears and say, "You are dreaming, you are dreaming," in the dream? Or even better, Inception, where they have their headphones in and listen to No Regrets by that woman, French woman, I can't remember, and they can hear it in the dream. It's cool stuff. So I'll leave a link to the article below, and I'll also leave a link to Daniel Love's live stream where he goes into a lot more detail about this kind of thing. But yeah, this is big news, big news, big news. Let me know what you think. I'm really eager to hear your views in the comment section below. So until Monday,